Hello students, in this section we are going to learn how to capture live data, or you can say volatile data, from the suspect's computer system. We are just taking an example that the suspect's computer is running a Windows OS. So for that purpose, we are going to use our favorite tool, that is Access Data's FDK Imager. As you know, in the very beginning I had told you that there are two options. You can go to File, and if you want to take the copy of the hard disk, if you want to acquire the evidences from the hard disk of the suspect, you simply need to go to create disk image. But this time we are interested in capturing all the evidences that may be stored on the RAM, that is all the live data or all the volatile data. In short, the volatile data is something which may get deleted once your computer is shut down. They are for a temporary period of time, so we have to make sure that the computer is kept on for the entire process until we capture the entire evidences from that RAM. In short, it is also called as RAM dump. So we are going to perform this RAM dump using this simple tool, Access Data FDK Imager. So what you need to do is you need to simply click on File and go to Capture Memory. And then you need to give a path. Let me give it a path as our evidence folder. For example, let me go to my evidence folder. And this is my evidence folder, okay, K01. And let me make a new folder called as RAM dump. I will be storing all the live data over there. And you can give any name you wish. Don't change the extension and click capture memory. It will take some 1 or 2 minutes for the entire process to get completed. And once it is done, you will be having your RAM dump. So memory capture is finished successfully. What you can do is you can close this, go to the actual location where you have stored your evidence. I guess it is over here. Go to FDK Imager case 1 and RAM dump. As you can see, this is your RAM dump file, or the live evidence file. Now only one thing remaining over here is you need to take the hash value of it also, so that whenever you are sharing this with any of the forensic investigators, you have to make sure that no data has been tampered with. So what you can do is you can simply go to your browser and type md5 sum, and you will get something like this. Fine, so you need to download a particular file, that is md5 in Windows, and you will get something like this. Go over there and download this file. After installing this file, what you can do is, let me show you. It is present over here. You can simply read the contents, how to install it, etc., etc. What you can do is you can simply extract this. Let me extract this on my desktop. Then you can simply copy this MD5 sums file and paste it in your evidence folder, that is present somewhere over here. It's very simple from here. Now you simply need to open command prompt from within this particular directory. So simply go to the explorer on top, type cmd and press enter. This will make sure that this particular file, MD5 sums, is opened inside this particular file itself, is opened inside this particular directory itself. Otherwise, you need to go to your main command prompt and then press CD and then change the directory. To avoid all that hassles, it's very simple to open CMD from here only. The next what you can do is, you simply need to type MD5 sums, SUMS, followed by the file name, that is MEM dump along with the extension, and simply press enter. You will be displayed with a particular progress bar over here, and what it will do is it will create an md5 sum for your file memdump.mem. So this is very handy, because if you take the hash value right now, and if you take the hash value even after hundreds of years, it is going to be same, provided there is no change in the data. if there is even a single line of change or even a single bit of change in the data, then it will cause a huge change in the hash output. That is what we call as avalanche effect. We are all aware of it, right? So basically, hashing is done for integrity checks. As we know, there are three goals of security: confidentiality, integrity, and availability. Hashing is performed to maintain integrity of the data, just to check whether the data is unmodified, whether the data is as accurate as possible. Hashing can be done to verify that. So just wait for a minute. This hashing operation will be done and I will be back. So as you can see, the hash is generated. You can simply copy this value and paste it somewhere. Let me copy this. Let me create a new file. And let me save that value over here. So along with this file, you should also send this MD5 sum output so that the receiver can just verify whether this file has been modified or not during the transit. So now I hope you know how to capture real evidences from the target's system with the help of this tool, FTK Imager. So we have almost come to the end. Only one section is remaining, that is how to recover the evidences back from these images that we have created so far. So I will be taking one or two examples with the help of one or two tools, and I will be showing you how to recover these evidences or data back from those images. So stay tuned.